Good morning and welcome to family time this morning. It's great to welcome you into the church. We used church last week while we're not having a congregation anymore. We're trying to explore bits of the church. And you may have guessed by the opening picture, we're going to be exploring stained glass today. But shall we pray as we begin? Loving Lord, thank you once more for gathering us as your family, for all those that will see this now, with us now, those that will join this family later on. We thank you for this great family of the church and pray your blessing upon us as we explore your love for us. Amen. Okay, well, it's lovely to see you. Now, this week you'll realise, or you might not realise, I can't see who's on. So whoever's joining, it's lovely to have you with us. Sorry, I'm not going to be naming names because I can't see. Otherwise, I'll have to run back and forth all the time. But it means that we won't be mirrored, so we can actually see the windows as you see them when you come into church. But we thought, what a great opportunity. Maybe when you come into church other times, you don't get a moment to stop and look at some of the stained glass. And stained glass, I love personally, because it helps tell a story. It helps us to be reminded there are some pictures of angels, there's different characters that we see from the Bible or from history, and it's just a great way of telling a story. And we've got lots of different styles of stained glass in St. Andrews. Now, further up the other end, we're not going to be going to those today. We've got some old, quite old windows, bearing in mind when the church was first built. We'll touch on that in a minute. But we do have different styles as well. We've got quite modern, the one we're going to concentrate on. But if we swing to the right at the wall this way, this is a more traditional, what we call more traditional stained glass. This is from the early 1900s, 20th century, and on this we get different stories, or we get different characters to help us tell stories. So in this particular window, we've got Sarah and Abraham from the Old Testament. We've got Elizabeth, who is the mother of John the Baptist, cousin of the Blessed Virgin Mary, who of course is the mother of Jesus, always coming to Advent and Christmas, so all the more relevant, of course. And indeed, she is holding Jesus in this particular window. So it's a lovely display. And even though they're dressed in a way they wouldn't have been in their day, they're dressed more in keeping with the Western style of dress a while ago, it's a reminder of these characters to help us think about their stories in the Bible. So it's really useful. Above, we've got angels looking down. That says that God is always looking out for us. Now, if we come across here, this is a particularly special window. It's the last window we've had placed in the church. And I wonder if you can see any dates, as in numerical dates, not edible dates. I wonder if you can see any dates in the window, which will help us to place it. Just give you a second to have a look. Well, I will show you if you haven't found them. We've got one over on this side, buried in the sort of brown, quite dark. But you get 1391, 1391. Now that was the year when St. Andrews was became a parish church. And in the image below, we get King Richard granting a deed to William of Wickham, who was a bishop in the Church of England, to have the land at St. Andrew. So we've got that date there, 1391, when the church became a parish church. Although there are bits in the church which are older than 1391, because we believe there's been a church here definitely since the 1100s, when there was a priory here, but probably, because it was a piece of high ground, there was a church in the 1000s as well, we suspect. But anyway, if we come to the other side, there's another date, and you can see it in the green there, 1991. So can you guess when this window was put in? Yep, it was to celebrate the 600th anniversary of St. Andrew's Church being the parish church in this area. So a really important window, because it gives us a lot of history. don't know if you can go right the way to the top of the window, because we get to see two, in effect, coats of arms. Now, on the right, we've got St. Andrew's, the saltire flag of St. Andrew's. On the left, we've actually got the coat of arms of William of Wickham. And we see that, that's carved on the outside of the church. We see it in different windows in the church as well, because of the importance of William in developing St. Andrew's as a parish church. But then, if we start coming down onto this, the left-hand window, what we realise is that William, what he did, he used the lands, he bought all the lands, the parish church and the lands, and some of the taxes that he received from this area went into developing new college in Oxford, what became Oxford University. And so right the way down here, you might see the writing there, New College. And so we've got St. Andrew's Church there, and we've got New College in the background. And there is a similarity in architectural styles between the two to suggest they were done at the same sort of time. So we've got St. Andrew's Church here. Of course, in the parish, we have lots of different, we've got three church buildings. And so I am creaking as I walk along this bench, I realise. In the middle, we have St. George's. And then on the right-hand side, we have St. Matthew's. So we've got the spread of our church buildings within the parish. And beautiful representations of Matthew. You can see the bell of St. George's and the cross on the wall of St. Matthew's, really beautifully done. But then when we think about the history of the parish, we come up to this right-hand side and we get to see a bit more of what was going on in 1991, I suppose. We've gone from the history of 1391 to 1991, and when we were looking at St. Matthew's, probably saw the Ford Fiesta car at the bottom. We've got a computer. Yes, that's what they used to look like. That clumsy and big. I know everything's on a tablet or a thin laptop now, but that's a computer. But we also start to see how the church was changing in those days as well. We've got women priests coming in, but also we've got remembrance of, last week was Remembrance Sunday. We've got the Spitfires from the Second World War, remembering RAF Hornchurch. So we've got so many different things going on. And throughout it, we have the reminder that there's the how important family is to the life of the church, and the people actually being in church, receiving communion, worshipping and praising God. So we get to see this real history of St. Andrew's listed in this one picture. Of course, what we haven't looked at fully at the moment is if we come into the middle, then this is the most important image of all, because here we have the image of Christ, Jesus Christ himself, and because his arms reach through history, it's a reminder that it's the eternal presence of God in the life of, well, in the life of the world, but in the life of our church. And this idea of him being connecting us from 1391 all the way to 1991, and of course all the way to today as well. As I mean, if we did this picture today, it would look very differently, wouldn't it? We'd have a different style of computer, we'd have laptops, we'd have live streaming, we'd have all sorts of different things going on. But it does remind me, I'm going to duck out of the room and make not so much noise, but it does remind us of the psalm. So this pew is so creaky, no wonder it's at the side and not used very often. In the psalm for today, it was Psalm 90, and just the first line really sums it up. Lord, you have been our dwelling place throughout all generations. This idea throughout all time, God has been our place of comfort, our rest, and this church building represents a place where we can come to worship and to celebrate and to meet one another throughout the centuries. Obviously, we're in a hiccup at the moment. We can't come together to meet, but we will meet again once lockdown is over, and as we move through this period, this will continue to be a place of meeting and worship. And I don't know if you knew that you're in this picture, in this window already. We all are in this picture, in this balancing on a pew while holding the phone. I don't know if you can see these individual bits of window here, and all the way through you get the images of people in these windows, and you get that sense of that's us through the centuries. People who have worshipped here in the past, those people that will worship in the future, that we are constantly a church. We're a church worshipping God, and we are protected and kept under the loving guidance and eyes of our Lord Jesus Christ, who through his grace we come to know God, to have the life that we have, and the one we can be thankful for. Now, of course, there's so much more. There's different coats of arms I could have talked about. There's so much other things that we could have gone into, talked about the different colours, but we haven't got time for all of that. If Molly wants to just spin around a little bit from there, we were reminded of the other windows, and you can see a little bit into the distance. I'm just seeing what Marlene's seeing. Yeah, in the distance, you can see our side chapel. That's some of our oldest windows. And that was actually blown out during the Second World War, but was then pieced back together to lots of different bits of the windows brought together. And so that's more history, more of the story of St. Andrew's Church. And for the moment, I realised I've been talking for ages. I'm going to come into the picture just as we come to the end of our time together. I hope that's been of interest. I hope when you next come in, you will be able to kind of come over and pick up on the window for yourself and go, oh, this, that and the other. Or maybe even look up some of the coats of arms or some of the colouring and just work out what it might mean for you, what was being said in that window when it was crafted, when the people that did it, I don't know if you heard Dawn's sermon earlier, they were using their gifts and talents to serve the church, to serve God, by using their artistic skills. And of course, within that picture, we celebrate all sorts of gifts, of inventions, of teaching, of using administration, there's so many different things we're thinking about in there. So hopefully lots for you to take away from today and to be thinking about. Thank you for joining us. As ever, it's great that we're a family, that we can come together. And shall we pray as we look ahead to this week that is before us? Dear God, thank you that we can share with one another and we can share our gifts and talents. Look to your love, look to your overarching love, knowing that your arms are there surrounding us, linking us from through history into the future. You are always there for us, and I pray that we will know your love with us as we go through this week in lockdown, but in whatever we are doing, whether we're at home, at school, at work, however it works, that we will know your love and your blessing. Amen. Thank you for being with us today. God bless you. Have a great week, and see you soon. And I'm going to leave Marlene to decide where she's going to focus as we leave. You take care. Bye for now.